Welcome back to the next session of statistics class. We are in the process of studying bivariate distributions. Now today, let me introduce correlation. It is a study of two variables at a time. What does it mean actually? Let's see a small example, price and demand. Whenever there is a change in the value of one variable, we are noticing a corresponding change in the value of other variable. Again, I am repeating this point. Whenever there is a change in the value of one variable, we are noticing a corresponding change in the value of other variable. So, in this particular case, whenever there is a movement in the values of the two variables, then to find out the nature of the relationship between the two variables and the extent of relationship between the two variables, we use a statistical tool called correlation. Fine. So, next point, the correlation is a statistical tool. The correlation is a statistical tool which studies the relationship between two variables. And the correlation analysis involves various methods and techniques used for studying and measuring the extent of relationship between the two variables Now look at this point once again. Correlation means it is a study of two variables at a time, and the correlation is a statistical tool which studies the relationship between two variables. Now, regression analysis. In regression, how we define the definition? It is a statistical tool which is used for forecasting. Here, correlation is a statistical tool which studies the relationship between two variables. It means whenever there is a change in the value of one variable, what will be the change in the value of other variable? In some cases, both the variables are moving in the same direction, and in some cases, the variables are moving in opposite direction. Okay, that way, whenever there is a change in the value of one variable, then what will be its effect on the value of other variable is the study of correlation. What is given here? The correlation is a statistical tool which studies the relationship between two variables, and correlation analysis involves various methods and techniques used for studying and measuring the extent of relationship between the two variables. two variables are said to be correlated. Two variables are said to be correlated. If the change in one variable results a corresponding change in the value of other variable when will I say two variables are correlated? Corresponding to a change in the value of one variable, if there is a change in the value of other variable, then only we can say the two variables are correlated. Otherwise, there is no correlation at all. Next point, when the values of two variables move in the same direction, then correlation is said to be positive or direct. When the values of two variables move in the same direction, then correlation is said to be positive or direct. Examples are, in economics you studied price and supply. Here both the variables are moving in the same direction. When the values of two variables move in opposite direction, then correlation is said to be negative or inverse. When the values of two variables move in opposite direction, then correlation is said to be negative or inverse. Example for this is demand and price. Okay. In addition to this, there is one more relation we have to discuss, that is linear correlation. Then after that, we can move to the various methods we have to study the correlation. Let us see one more definition, that is one more variety here. Corresponding to a unit change in the value of one variable, if the change in the value of other variable is a constant, corresponding to a unit change in the value of one variable, the change in the value of other variable is a constant, then it is called a linear correlation. In case of a linear correlation, in case of a linear correlation, the graph is a straight line. In case of a linear correlation, the graph is a straight line. So, with this basic knowledge in correlation, that is various definitions, let us see in detail about how to find out the correlation between two variables, what are the methods we have, and how to calculate the correlation. Methods of studying correlation. Methods of studying correlation. First one is scatter diagram. Scatter diagram. Second one is Carl Pearson's coefficient of correlation. Carl Pearson's coefficient of correlation or product moment correlation. Product moment correlation. Third one is Spearman's rank correlation. Spearman's rank correlation. Fourth one is method of concurrent deviations. Method of concurrent deviations. Now, scatter diagram is a graphical representation of finding out the nature of relationship between the two variables. Again, I am repeating this point. Scatter diagram is a graphical representation of finding out the nature of relationship between the two variables. That is, whether the correlation is positive or correlation is negative, or is there any correlation between the two variables or not. To this extent only this scatter diagram will tell. It cannot give you any value, numerical value. Means through scatter diagram we cannot find out the extent of relationship between the two variables. Whereas remaining three will give you a numerical value, that is to what extent the two variables are correlated with each other. So, first let us discuss Carl Pearson's coefficient of correlation, then we will go for Spearman's rank correlation, then method of concurrent deviations, finally I will come back to scatter diagram. Now, coefficient of correlation. Is denoted by the letter R. Coefficient of correlation is denoted by the letter R. So Carl Pearson coefficient of correlation. Carl Pearson's coefficient of correlation is the ratio of covariance of two variables x and y to the product of standard deviations of the variables x and y respectively. Okay, symbolically how can we represent r is equal to covariance of x comma y divided by standard deviation of x into standard deviation of y. R is equal to covariance of, in the short form it is written as COV, covariance of x comma y divided by standard deviation of x into standard deviation of y. Okay, we know how to calculate covariance of x comma y. This is summation of x minus x bar into y minus y bar by n. And standard deviation of x is equal to summation of x minus x bar whole square by n under root. Standard deviation of y is summation of y minus y bar whole square by n under root. So if I substitute these values, so summation of x minus x bar into y minus y bar by n, 1 by summation of x minus x bar whole square by n under root into summation of y minus y bar whole square by n under square root of n into square root of n is n, n and this n cancel, leaving with summation of x minus x bar into y minus y bar by summation of x minus x bar whole square into summation of y minus y bar whole square under. So there is another formula for finding out the correlation. Summation of x minus x bar into y minus y bar divided by under root of summation of x minus x bar whole square and summation of y minus y bar whole square. Now, whenever deviations are taken from actual means, it can also be written as this way. Summation of xy by summation of x square under root into summation of y square under root. Summation of xy by summation of x square into summation of y square. This way also you can convert the formula. This is first one, this is second one, this is third one. Okay. Next, there is one more way of representation, summation of x by minus summation of x into summation of y by n. Summation of x square minus summation of x whole square by n under root into summation of y square minus summation of y whole square by n under. There is one more formula to calculate r value, that is when totals are given, when deviations are taken from, when deviations are taken from actual means, when deviations are taken from assumed means or assumed values, r is equal to summation of dx dy minus summation of dx into summation of dy by n. Where dx is equal to x minus a, dy is equal to y minus b, a comma b are assumed values. So which formula I have to use, that is entirely dependent on the data given to you. Based on that, we can go for calculations. Okay. Now, properties of correlation coefficient. First one. The value of r is independent of units of measurement. What does it mean actually? The value of r means after calculations are over, there is no units per r. You cannot write the answer in terms of rupees or in terms of kilograms or in terms of inches. Fine. So it's a units per measurement. Second one, the value of r lies from minus 1 to plus 1. The value of r lies from minus 1 to plus 1. That is, minus 1 is less than or equal to r, r is less than or equal to 1. Minus 1 is less than or equal to r, and r is less than or equal to 1. When r is equal to minus 1, there is a perfect negative correlation. There is a perfect negative correlation between the two variables. And the graph is a straight line. Falling from left top to right bottom. Left top to right bottom. So the scatter diagram is this way. It is falling from left top to right bottom. Graph or scatter diagram one and the same. So when r is equal to minus 1, there is a perfect negative correlation between the two variables and the graph is a straight line falling from left top to right bottom. Next, when r is equal to 0, there is no linear relationship. No linear relationship between the two variables. Between the two variables. When r is equal to 0, there is no linear relationship between the two variables. When r is equal to plus 1, there is a perfect positive, there is a perfect positive correlation, perfect positive correlation between the two variables, between the two variables, and the graph is a straight line rising from left bottom to right top. Rising from left bottom to right top. In this case, the graph is this way. When r is equal to plus 1, there is a perfect positive correlation between the two variables and the graph is a straight line rising from left bottom to right top. These points you have to remember. Fine. Next one. Next point, correlation coefficient. Independent of change of origin and scale. Correlation coefficient is independent of change of origin and scale. If u is equal to ax plus b, v is equal to cy plus d, r of u comma v is a into c by modulus of a into c multiplied with r of x comma y. R of u comma v is equal to a into c by modulus of a into c and this ratio multiplied with r of x comma 1. R of x comma 1. Next, if two variables x and y are related by ax plus by plus c equal to 0. If two variables x and y are related by ax plus by plus c equal to 0, then r is equal to minus 1 when x coefficient comma y coefficient have same sign. R is equal to minus 1 when x coefficient and y coefficient have same sign. R is equal to plus 1 when x coefficient comma y coefficient have opposite sign. Have opposite sign. Okay, sir. Let us see some numerical problems based on this. Question number 1. Given R of x comma y is equal to 0.8 and 2u plus 3x plus 4 equal to 0 and 4v plus 16y plus 11 equal to 0. Then R of u comma v is equal to question mark. R of u comma v is equal to question mark. So this problem is based on change of horizon and scale property. Look at this solution. 2u is equal to minus 3x minus 4. U is equal to minus 3 by 2 into x minus 4 by 2. This is of the type ax plus b. 4b is equal to minus 16y minus 11. V is equal to minus 4y minus 11 by 4. This is cy plus d. R of u comma v is equal to R of ax plus b comma cy plus d. So this is a into c by modulus of a into c r of x comma y. A is equal to minus 3 by 2, c is equal to minus 4 divided by modulus of minus 3 by 2 into minus 4 multiplied with 0.8. Numerator is a positive value. Minus into minus plus modulus absolute value is always positive. So you can cancel these two. This is R of x comma y. R of u comma v is equal to R of x comma y. Okay, let us see the second question. Question number 2. If u plus 5x is equal to 6 and 3y minus 7v is equal to 20 and R of x comma y is equal to 0.58, R of u comma v is question mark. R of u comma v is question mark. Okay, let us see the solution of this. U is equal to minus 5x plus 6. Take 5x to the right hand side. This positive value will become negative. Minus 7v is equal to minus 3y plus 20. V is equal to 3 by 7 into y minus 20 by 7. This is of the type ax plus b. This is of the type cy plus d. A is equal to minus 5, C is equal to 3 by 7. 3 by 7. Now R of u comma v is equal to A into C by modulus of A into C, R of x comma y. Minus 5 into 3 by 7 by modulus of minus 5 into 3 by 7 multiplied with 0.5. So R of u comma v, numerator is a negative value minus 15 by 7, denominator is a positive value 15 by 7 multiplied with 0.58, minus 1 into 0.58, minus 0.58. R of u comma v is equal to minus R of x comma y. R of u comma v is equal to minus R of x comma y. Let's see the third question. If the relation between x and u is 3x plus 4u is equal to 7, and R of x comma y is equal to minus 0.6, R of u comma y is equal to question mark. Or you can write R of u comma v is equal to question mark. Anyway, both are one and the same. Let us see in which way both are one and the same. I tell you here. 4u is equal to minus 3x plus 7. U is equal to minus 3 by 4 into x plus 7 by 4. Let us take v is equal to y. When I take v is equal to y, then R of u comma y and R of u comma v one and the same. So this is again written as 1 into y plus 0. Now this is of the type u is equal to ax plus b. Second one is of the type v is equal to cy plus d. R of u comma v is equal to a into c by modulus of a into c, R of x comma y. Minus 3 by 4 into 1 by modulus of minus 3 by 4 into 1 multiplied with minus 0.6. Minus 3 by 4 by plus 3 by 4 into minus 0.6. Minus 1 into 0.6, minus 0.6, 0.6. So R of u comma v is equal to minus R of x comma y. Let us see the next question. Question number 4. X is equal to 23547. Y is equal to 467810. R of x comma y is equal to 0.93. Now u is equal to -3 -2 0 -1 2. V is equal to -4 -2 -1 0 2. R of u comma v is equal to question mark. R of u comma v is equal to question mark. Now, let's say instead of giving a straightforward relation here, it is given in an indirect way. Very simple question. Let us see the analysis of this. The third value of the variable u is 0. Third value of the variable u is 0. What is the third value of the variable x? 5. 5 is the third value of the variable x. Now look at this, 2 minus 5 is minus 3, 3 minus 5 is minus 2, 5 minus 5 is 0, 4 minus 5 is minus 1, 7 minus 5 is 2. So you can write u is equal to x minus 5. You can write u is equal to x minus 5. Fourth value of the variable v is 0. Fourth value of the variable v is 0. Here also fourth value of the variable y 8. Here fourth value of the variable y is 8. 4 minus 8 is minus 4. 6 minus 8 is minus 2. 7 minus 8 is minus 1. 8 minus 8 is 0. 10 minus 8 2. So v can be written as y minus 8. V can be written as y minus 8. This is from the given information only. The relation is derived from the given information. Now, you can write u is equal to, this is x minus 5. V is equal to y minus 8. This is of the type ax plus b. This is cy plus b. A is equal to 1. C is equal to 1. R of u comma v is equal to a into c by modulus of a into c multiplied with r of x comma y, 1 by 1 into 0.93. So r of u comma v is equal to r of x comma y. Okay, let's see one more question. Question number 5. U is equal to 10. 15, 25, 20, and this is 35. V is equal to minus 24, minus 36, minus 42, minus 48, minus 60. R of u comma v is question mark. R of u comma v is question mark. Now you have to identify how the values of u and v are obtained. If it is clear, that is how the values of u and v are written, this question is as simple as anything. Look at this, sir. When each value of x is multiplied with 5, when each value of x is multiplied with 5, that is one way. Or look at this, u by x is equal to 5. 10 by 2 is 5, 15 by 3 is 5, 25 by 5 is 25 by 5 is 5, 20 by 4 is 5, 35 by 7 is 5. Implies u is equal to 5x. U is equal to 5x. Now look at this, v divided by y is equal to minus 6. V divided by y is equal to minus 6. Minus 24 by 4, minus 6, minus 36 by 6, minus 6, minus 42 by 7, minus 6, minus 48 by 8, minus 6, minus 60 by 10 is minus 6. So v is equal to minus 6y. V is equal to minus 6y. Now you can write u is equal to 5x, v is equal to minus 6y. A is equal to 5, C is equal to minus 6. So minus 30 by modulus of minus 30 into 0.93. Minus 1 into 0.93, this is minus 0.93. Minus R of u x comma y. Therefore, R of u comma v is equal to minus R of x comma y. Let's see the next question. Question number 6. If the relationship between two variables x and y is given by x plus 3y plus 4 equal to 0, then R of x comma y is question mark. See the solution. What is given? The relationship between two variables x and y is given by 2x plus 3y plus 4. When x and y are related by ax plus by plus c equal to 0, when x and y are related by ax plus by plus c equal to 0, r is equal to minus 1, when x coefficient comma y coefficient have same sign, when x coefficient comma y coefficient have same sign, R is equal to plus 1 when x coefficient comma y coefficient have opposite sign. Now the given problem is 2x plus 3y plus 4 equal to 0. X coefficient is positive, y coefficient is positive, both are positive values. Plus 3 it is a positive value, plus 2 it is a positive value, they have same sign, they have same sign. When they have same sign, what is the value of R? Therefore R is equal to minus 1. R is equal to minus 1. Okay, let's see the next question. Given covariance of x comma y is equal to 40, variance of x is equal to 60, variance of y is equal to 256, r is equal to question mark, r is equal to question mark. Now R is equal to covariance of x comma y divided by standard deviation of x into standard deviation of y. 40 by 16 under root into 256 under root. 40 divided by 4 into 16. 10 divided by 16, 5 by 8. This is 5 divided by 8. 5 divided by 8, 0.625. Let's see the next question. Question number 8. If covariance of x comma y is equal to 15, what restrictions should be put for standard deviations of x and y? Now how to answer this question? See the solution. Covariance of x comma y may be positive comma 0 or negative. When covariance of x comma y is positive, R is also positive. When covariance of x comma y is 0, R is also 0. When covariance of x comma y is negative, R is also negative. R is also negative. Remember these three points. Here, covariance is a numerical number of positive value. We know R value lies from minus 1 to plus 1. R value lies from minus 1 to plus 1. Now in this case, covariance is positive, so R cannot be negative. All these values are eliminated from the picture. All these negative values are eliminated from the picture. Covariance is a numerical number, so R is also a numerical number. Covariance, R value cannot be zero. Therefore, this is also eliminated, zero also. What is the original inequality we have? Minus 1 is less than or equal to R. R is less than or equal to 1. From the given information, this inequality is converted into 0 is less than R, R is less than or equal to 1. So 0 less than or less than covariance of x comma y less than or equal to 1. So covariance of x comma y must be less than or equal to standard deviation of x into standard deviation of y. Or standard deviation of x into standard deviation of y must be greater than or equal to covariance of x comma y. Greater than or equal to 50. It is greater than or equal to 50. Okay, let's see the next question. For the bivariate data, this is 12, 6, 9, 9. Write this way: 13, 5, 14, 4, 15, 3, 16, 2. R of x, y is equal to question mark. 12, 6, 13, 5, 14, 4, 15, 3, 16, 2. Straightforward observation, x values are increasing, y values are decreasing. Therefore, the correlation is negative. Corresponding to a change in the value of one variable. The value of other variables are decreasing, means x values. The value of x is increasing, the value of y is decreasing. So, the values of two variables are moving in opposite direction. When the values of two variables are moving in opposite direction, then correlation is said to be negative. That is one way of identification. One more point to notice here. Sum of the two variables in each bracket is a constant. Sum of the two variables in each bracket is a constant. 12 + 6 = 18. 13 + 5 = 18, 14 + 4 = 18, 15 + 3 = 18, 16 + 2 = 18. So this can also be written as x plus y is equal to 18. Or you can say x plus y minus 18 equal to 0. This is of the type ax plus by plus c equal to 0. X coefficient is positive. Y coefficient is positive. Means both are having same sign. When X coefficient come up, Y coefficient have same sign. When X coefficient comma Y coefficient have same sign, R is minus 1. This is another way of solving the question. This is another way of solving. Any way you can solve, that doesn't make any difference. Okay, that's all in this. Remaining in the next session. Thank you.